I wanted to talk a little bit more about language today, given that it's the medium through which most of philosophy is done. It's something that we don't usually talk about. It's something that we use as a way to talk about other things, but it in itself is always kind of underneath the covers. When we talk about things, it's usually mediated by some kind of concept, and that concept is an abstract representation of something we may have experienced in the world, or some kind of knowledge that we might have that allows us to navigate the world in a way that makes it comprehensible for us. But in order for these concepts to come to the foreground, it usually requires some level of thinking. If I say a new concept that you might not be familiar with, you don't really have any past experience from which to fall back on to really understand that concept. So you have to go and think about it. You might want to think about the word itself, or you might want to think about the way I use the word and how that might kind of fit in with the rest of my language. But it's that thinking that is important, or what I want to touch on today, because the thinking is mediated through that concept. The thinking directly engages with that concept, but it doesn't engage with the world. Between that concept and your thinking, the world still exists out there, but you are mostly kind of giving your pure focus on language or the concept. Now, if we think of other concepts that we're actually more familiar with, we don't have to go through that thinking process because we already understand them. We're familiar with them to a degree that they just kind of happen. Something that Marvin Minsky said, one of the founders of AI, that has stuck with me is he's talking, he was having an interview, and he's saying, "What is kind of remarkable about intelligence or human intelligence is that I don't really understand the process through which I'm communicating to you even right now. The words that are coming out of my mouth are not as a result of me thinking them, but it is kind of a spontaneous thing that has happened, maybe possibly due to habit. But how is it even possible to have habits? You know, that is something that we can really respect." And thus, whereas we think of philosophy as something where we're always constantly thinking, it can actually be something that is more habit-driven. The more we use language, the more we use concepts, the more we read, the more familiar we become with certain words, and the more we're able to spontaneously say things that we put them into the world that have some kind of meaningful content. And I presume the way you become familiar with words or concepts is to kind of dwell on them, to think about them. You have to kind of go through that process before you can really start to use the words in a way where it feels natural, where you don't have to think about it, where you can simply speak, and the words and the concepts that you use map very nicely or satisfyingly to the world or the situation that you're in.